With the Canucks unable to find any takers for Roberto Luongo, the probability of Corey Schneider being moved is looking more and more like a reality. Having a cap hit only $1.3 million lower than Luongo's, the conventional wisdom has turned from Luongo must go to Schneider being the only one the club is capable of moving for true value. The Canucks have suffered numerous injuries, and it's unlikely they can hold out another season in hopes of moving Luongo because of the immediate needs of the club. Schneider is only 27 years old and will give any team a quality NHL starter for the next decade, as his best years are still in front of him.
When you look at the numbers, it is a clean sweep for Corey Schneider. More wins, lower goals against average, better save percentage, and the much more attractive contract. So far, everyone has said, in the case of Roberto Luongo, tweeted the right thing, but the elephant in the room continues to take up a lot of space. Let's bring in now our Vancouver Canucks panel.
Thanks so much. Don Taylor here with a couple of ex-Canucks, Gary Volk and Brad May, both of them looking good, although I think I've got the best tie. Okay, guys, in the million-dollar question in Vancouver, does Roberto Luongo finally get traded before the deadline? Does it happen tomorrow?
If Vancouver trades Roberto Luongo, they're going to have to get a significant piece that can come in and join their, you know, forward group, or if it's a defenseman, and actually play significant minutes for the Vancouver Canucks. Otherwise, I don't see Roberto Luongo leaving Vancouver. I think his value, even if he's a backup goaltender, it takes over 20 players to win the Stanley Cup. That is exactly what the Vancouver Canucks want and expect to do. I think Roberto Luongo is a big piece. He may be the goaltender that takes them there as well. Unless they get somebody great in return, I say stand pat, move them in the summer if that's their mission. Gary.
Well, for me, it's Corey Schneider all the way, and he's proven that to me the last 2 weeks of this season. The Canucks haven't scored a ton of goals. We know that. Schneider's been the one consistent. He's been there game in, game out. He is the man going forward to the playoffs. I don't agree with keeping an asset on the bench like Luongo when you need have definite concerns up front or on D. You have concerns on your team that if you can get a player back in return, you get that player and you get rid of Luongo. I have no problems in getting rid of him. Yes, you need a backup somewhere. Bring a backup back in for him.
But you don't remove Roberto Luongo for a pick or somebody that can't step in and be an impact player for the Vancouver
Canucks. You remove him for the contract.
No, you do that in the summertime. You don't do it before. You may need this guy.
Yeah. And Mike Gillis has said, yesterday, as a matter of fact, that he thinks it might come to that Roberto Luongo will indeed move in the summer. All right, let's move on to Derek Roy. The Canucks pick him up from Dallas, and so much for the Stars and Canucks organizations not getting along because of previous ownership battles. What is Derek Roy going to add to the Vancouver Canucks, Gary?
Well, he's got a pedigree of huge point seasons, Donnie. He's got 60-point seasons, 70 points, 80-point seasons. He can score. This team is awful on the power play for the most year. They've been bad for 60 games if you include the playoffs last year and the last 20 games. He's a playoff type player who can score. He's gritty. He's fun. Look, he's not real hot right now, Brad. He's only got one goal in his last 13 games, so he's not real hot, but I think a change of scenery will be great for Roy.
I don't disagree. I watched him in Buffalo for many years, and this player was the MVP in the Memorial Cup. He's played in a couple World Championships. Derek Roy's got that skill set that Vancouver desperately needs. It certainly shores up, in their top six. Derek Roy's going to be an impact player. He's going to have to get on the board, no question, but he definitely has a great skill set that could play either on the first line or the second line, certainly on the power play.
Not great on faceoffs, though, Donnie. Only 46% in there to a team that's 27th in the league. Not great on faceoffs. They may have to bring in somebody for that role as well.
All right, Chris Higgins signs also with the Canucks, 4 years, $10 million. We're running out of time here, so let's focus on something else, and that's the fact that the Canucks made a play for Ryan Clough today. Didn't get him. Rangers did. What does that tell you, man?
Well, it tells you that obviously the Vancouver Canucks are looking for physicality up front. Ryan Clough had no goals, but I'll tell you what, the intangibles he brings, he can change the element of a hockey game, and he's certainly a great teammate. I'm looking at Rafi Torres or other players like that that maybe Vancouver has an interest in that actually can be impact players in the playoffs. Rafi Torres, over the last couple seasons, has been that and knocking out the Chicago Blackhawks for both of his teams.
Canucks need more than Rafi Torres and players like that now. They can't score goals. They need goal scoring to take pressure off their defense and their goaltending. Goals, 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 Mike Gillis. That's all you should be looking for.
Will Roberto Luongo be traded by Mike Gillis? We'll find out, or we'll know it this time tomorrow. It is Brad May. It is Gary Volk. It is a Tuesday night.